In this video I will talk about kangaroo adaptation. Thank you for watching my video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like to this video. What makes a kangaroo different from a wallaby? Kangaroos are simply the largest members of the Macropus genus. The common wallaroo or Euro M, Robustus black wallaroo, Antilopine kangaroo, Eastern grey kangaroo M, Giganteus western grey kangaroo M, Fully genosus, red kangaroo, Macropus rufus, and antilopine kangaroo are among them. M. Bernardus. Classification: class Mammalia, order Diprotodontia. Family Macropodidae, genus Megalia, species Rufa. Habitat and range: the open plains, scrubland, grassland and desert of central Australia. The eastern grey kangaroos were given the name Kangaroo by the Guga Yimathir people of far north Queensland, which is where the word kangaroo comes from. Kangaroos have special cultural and spiritual significance for the Aboriginal people of Australia. Furthermore, their pelts were used to make clothing and rugs, the skin was used to make water bags, and their meat was and still is a primary source of nourishment. The kangaroo is the world's largest marsupial. A red kangaroo can reach 2 meters in height and weigh 90 kilograms. Black wallaroos are the smallest species, weighing about 20 kilograms. Their name a portmanteau of wallaby and kangaroo. Kangaroos are famous for their legendary hopping and can leap over 8 meters in a single bound. Description: kangaroos all have short hair, long tails, big feet, powerful hind legs, and small forelimbs. They have excellent hearing and vision. Depending on the species, their fur coat can be red, grey, or light to dark brown. Their powerful tail acts as an additional limb when moving around and aids in balance when jumping. Kangaroos are excellent swimmers who use their tails to propel themselves. They can use their forepaws to drown pursuers and swim away from predators. The kangaroo, as an animal that can only move forward, is depicted on the Australian coat of arms as a symbol of the country's progress. Kangaroos are well known for their forward opening pouch, which is where the joey baby kangaroo develops and suckles. A female kangaroo is referred to as a flyer or a doe, while a male kangaroo is referred to as a buck or a boomer, hence the nickname of Australia's men's basketball team, the Boomers. They live in mobs, which are social groups. Kangaroos live in Australia. Red kangaroos inhabit the majority of arid Australia, preferring flat open plains. Eastern greys can be found from Cape York to Tasmania, while western greys can be found from Western Australia to Victoria. Both species prefer denser vegetation. Antilopine kangaroos can be found throughout northern Australia in monsoonal tropical woodlands, and common wallaroos can be found throughout Australia, particularly near rocky outcrops. According to the IUCN Red List of Threatened Species, the black wallaroo is near threatened with extinction in the Northern Territory's sandstone country. The remaining species are widespread, common, and classified as least concern. Animal behavior: kangaroos, like all marsupials, have pouches where joeys are reared, drinking milk from mammary glands. Females have one young per year, but they can keep extra embryos dormant, embryonic diapause, until the first joey leaves the pouch. At the same time, they can have a joey at their feet, one in the pouch, and another in diapause. Surprisingly, each of the female's 4 teats provides different milk for the joeys at different stages of development. Kangaroos hiss and growl when threatened, females click to communicate with the young, and males chuckle during courtship. Kangaroos are most active between dusk and dawn, searching for their favorite foods, grass, leaves, ferns, flowers, and fruit. They regurgitate their food, chewing it twice before it passes through the chambered stomach, just like cattle. Kangaroos require free water to survive, however, when desperate, they have been known to dig a meter-deep hole in search of water. Kangaroos are under threat. Kangaroos have few natural predators: dingoes, humans, wedge-tailed eagles, and Tasmanian tigers before they were exterminated. Introduced carnivores like wild dogs and foxes prey on the young, and introduced herbivores compete for food with kangaroos. Because of the introduction of permanent water sources, bores, tanks, and dams the provision of pasture grasses, the extinction of Tasmanian tigers, and the extermination of dingoes across vast landscapes, European settlement has actually been beneficial to several kangaroo species. Kangaroos are overabundant in some areas, though this is not true for the antilopine kangaroo or the black wallaroo, whose populations are declining. Kangaroos are unable to walk forward or backward. To move around, they must jump or hop. They have powerful Z-shaped hind legs that propel them, as well as a large tail that helps them balance when sitting or moving. They occasionally walk on all fives, with the forelimbs and tail balancing the animal as the hind legs move forward. Kangaroos are the only bipedal marsupial that lives in Australia. Adaptation's marsupial pouch kangaroos are pouched marsupials. Females give birth very early in the embryonic development phase, and the extremely immature newborn must crawl up the mother's fur and into the pouch where it is protected while nursing and developing. Where it is extremely hot. Kangaroos have several adaptations for surviving in Australia's hot climate. They sweat while moving and pant when they stop exercising. They also have a dense network of blood vessels near the skin's surface on their forearms. They lick their forearms, allowing the wind to blow away the heat from the warm blood. Try the sleep or rest during the hottest part of the day and graze at night or early in the morning when it is cooler. Kangaroos are unable to walk forward or backward. To move around, they must jump or hop. They have powerful Z-shaped hind legs that propel them, as well as a large tail that helps them balance when sitting or moving. They occasionally walk on all fives, with the forelimbs and tail balancing the animal as the hind legs move forward. Kangaroos are the only marsupials that move on two legs rather than all four. Description of the physical form: male red kangaroos are about 6 feet, 1.8 meters tall, while females are about 3.5 feet, 1.1 meters tall. Males can weigh up to 175 pounds, 80 kilograms, while females rarely weigh more than 75 pounds, 34 kilograms. Males have red-brown fur, whereas females have blue-gray fur. Diet: what does it eat? Grasses, leaves, roots, and low, herbaceous plants in the wild. Hay, grain, and vegetables, as well as vitamin and mineral supplements, are available at the zoo. What consumes it? The red kangaroo is a large animal that deters most predators due to its strong legs and clawed feet. Dingoes do prey on kangaroos, and raptors may capture the young. Humans eat red kangaroo as well. Social behavior: red kangaroos live in small groups of 10 or fewer, but when food or water is scarce, they form larger groups. A mob of kangaroos is made up mostly of females with their offspring and one or two males. Red kangaroos are mostly nocturnal and spend the days in the shade. The life cycle: female kangaroos reach maturity at 15 to 20 months, while males reach maturity at 20 to 24 months. When seasonal conditions are favorable, red kangaroos can breed all year, and males will compete for mating opportunities with several females. The gestation period of red kangaroos is short, and the young are born only 33 days after mating. Joeys, or young kangaroos, are born in an immature state, averaging only 1 inch 2.5 centimeters in length and weighing 0.035 ounces, less than 1 gram. The tiny newborn crawls up the mother's fur into her pouch after birth and immediately attaches itself to a nipple. The joey remains permanently attached to the nipple for about 70 days, suckling and developing. Females carry their young for about a year while nursing them. For the first 8 months of their life cycle, they were carried in the pouch. Females may have one joey in the pouch, an older joey outside the pouch but still nursing, and a blastocyst in the process of implantation. Males do not help with child rearing. Male kangaroos leave their natal group when they reach maturity, whereas females stay. In the wild, red kangaroos can live for up to 22 years. In Australia, they are considered a nuisance animal because they cause fence damage, compete with livestock for grass and water, cause erosion, and pose a hazard to drivers. Kangaroo culling is part of Australia's wildlife management program. Kangaroos have long been used as a food source by Aboriginal Australians. They are a sacred animal in the Aboriginal culture and appear frequently in Aboriginal art and stories. Kangaroos are an Australian animal, so their natural habitats are deserts and grasslands. They've had to adjust to moving around on flat and sandy ground, as well as extreme heat. Kangaroos must survive on very little water when the heat causes droughts, long periods of time without rain. Kangaroos frequently use their legs to kick each other when fighting, and these blows can be fatal. People must be cautious because they will kick anyone who gets too close. Hopping on their large legs also conserves energy because only one part of their body is exerting significant effort. Finding food and water, which provides energy, can be difficult in such a hot climate, so conserving energy is critical. Excellent balance. Kangaroos have large, muscular tails that help them balance while hopping. They can reach speeds of over 50 km per hour, so the ability to move quickly without falling is critical. Remember that they live in open landscapes, so there aren't many places for predators to hide. If you can't hide, you have to outrun, or in this case, outjump. Because of their small arms, the front of their bodies aren't too heavy when they jump. These arms, however, are still extremely powerful. They can punch nearly as well as kick. Taking care of their children. Kangaroos are marsupials, which means they carry their young in a pouch when they are born. Conserving water during the summer, temperatures in Australia frequently exceed 30 degrees Celsius. Kangaroos cannot afford to waste any water in such a hot environment. The digestive systems are well adapted to deal with this. It ensures that the body retains as much water as possible. So even when kangaroos have to eat dried out plants, their bodies retain as much water as they can. Managing the heat aside from saving water, kangaroos have a plethora of tricks to help them survive hot temperatures. Two of them involve cooling through evaporation. If you have a dog, you may have noticed it panting when it gets hot. Kangaroos pant as well. Sticking their tongue out allows the moisture on it to evaporate, lowering their body temperature. Another way they cool off is by licking themselves all over. Again, as the moisture on their skin evaporates, their body temperature drops. Joeys can stay cool in their pouches, which is another way the pouch is a great adaptation. Thank you for watching my video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like to this video.